went back to school after the summer of 2014. It was pretty fun because everybody knew who we were after we told everybody about the band.
Some people actually knew who we were because of the name. Like, I think there's a Facebook page for the band, and so some people knew who we were. And then other people didn't know. We chose the band name, and you know, they thought the band name was hilarious, so they liked it. You know, went on Facebook and checked that out and stuff. But it was pretty cool coming back to school. Pretty cool.
So we started to play shows in the auditorium.
Blast off!
That's actually pretty good.
The auditorium shows were, we did our thing the first one. I don't really think anything went too bad, but we really didn't have enough time to play a lot.
So I'm singing.
But there was a lot of kids there, and it was a good time.
So Mr. Pate started to become a huge, want to say influence, but he became a huge part in helping us out. He would stick his neck out for us if we got in trouble for playing in the auditorium, and he would supervise it and everything. He was just a huge help. He brought in the bass. He told us what we could do to make it better.
You guys started playing. You were jamming out in the auditorium. What was it, 3 years ago? It must have been about 3 years now. And you guys had a lot of talent. And I tried to create an environment where you guys can practice on your own, get some access to some equipment, and then certainly be able to share your talents with the rest of the students. That was about 3 years ago.
And yeah, just having Mr. Pace around was great. He helped us out so much. And, you know, I'm really thankful for it.
You guys, I'm the facilitator. You guys do the work, and I just kind of point you in the right direction. And you guys ask questions along the way. And if I don't know the answer, I try to find one for you. So it's been about 2-3 years at this point. Yeah.
It was cool. Everybody knew who we were.
We'd go in the hall, people would be like, "Rusty Nipples." And little kids would say it. And like, everybody knew who we were. The adults even said it.
And everybody was into the band. One of the guidance counselors were telling me one time that Mr. Brown called her, asked her, "What is Rusty Nipples?" Like, he was dead serious. He must have thought it was like a drug or
something. And I even took the time to have my mom draw up a logo for the band. And, that's pretty cool, you know. And then I bought t-shirts to put on. We went around school asking people if they wanted t-shirts or not.
Got the shirts made and sold a bunch of them, and it was just a good time.
They got banned from school, actually, but I think me and Trey still wore ours. No one said a thing.
And everybody loved the name. I think they liked the name more better than the music. But
we thought we were serious, but a lot of people thought we were just like a joke. Because the name's, pretty funny, but I mean, we make music.
I will say though, I, 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 the name. I'm not a fan of the name, but I will call the group the name in protest of it. But again, that's certainly your creative it's your creative outlet, and that's just only my opinion.
So we finally started to play original songs by our third gig.
Well, I guess you guys were playing. You had some cool originals. I'd say definitely. I Can't Wait. I think that's got a lot of potential to kind of catch on. I think a lot of people kind of gravitated towards that tune. And then even some of the other jams that you were working on, just some outside the box thinking as far as chord changes and some of the timbres and sounds that you're able to get. Overall, that's kind of what I heard at first. It wasn't just the same. The same progression over and over with a capo on. I mean, there's some different stuff, different rhythmic ideas, and again, I think you guys are on the right track.
Playing covers is fun and all, but I mean, it just don't feel right because you're just playing other people's songs. I don't know, it's just my opinion on it, but I'm more proud when we play original. And it was cool, we started to demo our original songs. They were songs dating back to my old demo tape.
I remember Trey would have blank tapes, and we'd play a bunch of stuff down.
But still didn't have drums at the time, but Mr. Pates brought in his bass.
We had used guitar for the bass. Trey would show me the bass lines and I played my guitar. Then we came to school one day and Mr. Pace had a bass guitar he brought in. And I had never played a bass before. And brought it in and we started jamming on it. Like, oh man, fucking bass is awesome. And I was like, dude, I think I'm gonna be a bass player. And then Trey was like, dude, I think I might be a bass player.
Eventually, we started recording them with the actual drums and bass.
Drums are fun. They're fun. You get grooving and jamming. You get the right sound, and it sounds fucking sweet.
And Mr. Pace, again, helped us out a lot with that.
Certainly, anything I can do to help you out. As far as giving you a place to practice, giving you a place to use some equipment that you may not ordinarily have.
Yeah, we did those demos in the auditorium.
In our case, we had the venue was the auditorium.
What we would do is, at school, we'd record the drums and bass on a tape.
Hey, we did the bass and drums here. And the guitar stuff at Trey's house.
When we came over to my house to put the guitars and the vocals on, we just overlapped one tape onto the other by playing the bass and drums tape in the background, then adding the vocals and guitars over that. So we did that method for the education and because of our new demo.
They came out pretty cool. Pace recorded a couple of them on his iPad.
So then we got a gig to play at the school Spirit Day in April 2015, but the gig was in May. And then we didn't want to play as a two-piece anymore. We wanted to actually get a band together. So we asked our friend Logan O'Connell and Damon Emerson to help out with it.